I'm very proud to introduce our next speaker. He is an officer of the Stop the War Coalition, but more than that, he is the organizer of three land convoys, successful land convoys to Gaza. He is the co-sponsor of the flotilla, and he was on the Mavi Marmara, Kevin Ovenden.
Brothers and sisters, Ikhwani wa akhawati, Akadeshle. All has changed, and changed utterly. A new phase of our struggle has been born, but at a terrible, almost unbearable price. Nine brothers taken from us on the Mavi Marmara. Their blood now lapping at the shores of Gaza. But their blood was not shed in vain, because the tide has turned, and we must seize this tide and seize it now to make a lasting change for Palestine and in the Middle East and around the world. We remember those taken from us. I remember the brother in front of me, 1 meter in front of me, who was shot through the leg. The one 50 centimeters to the right of me, shot in the abdomen. I remember the photographer, shot through the forehead, the high velocity bullets blowing away the back third of his skull, cradled by a friend of mine, Nicky Enschmarch, as the last few seconds of his life expired. I remembered them on Monday night, bound in an Israeli dungeon in the Negev Desert, a place where any self-respecting friend of Palestine would be honoured to be. And what means this massacre on the Mavi Marmara? It means that the miasma of defeat which has settled through the Middle East and upon many of us for so long is now lifting, and we can begin to move forward. The question is not if this siege will end. The question is how long it will take and how this siege will end. And to achieve this, we need determination, and we need to think strategically about how we take our movement forward. There is now an attempt to isolate, to denigrate, to calumniate against the government, the people of Turkey, and in particular, the leading magnificent civil organization, the İHA, led by Chairman Bülent. Why do they seek to isolate Turkey, its people and its organizations? Because Turkey has been in the front rank of this battle. It paid the highest price. We, as a movement, cannot allow the Turkish movement to be isolated. And that means that around the world, from Vancouver to Lake Van, from Casablanca to Kuwait, from all four points of the compass, we must all step now into the front rank of this movement in order to take it forward. Every government must come under pressure to advance the position of the governments which have gone furthest. Every word from every international body must be accompanied by demands for action. I met some of the grieving relatives, relatives of people who were killed, some of them friends of mine, some of them people who I travelled with in December and January on the last convoy. Their message was clear. Israel is attempting to terrorize not only the Palestinians, but everybody who stands with them. But we are not afraid. We are not afraid today. This can be the beginning of the end. This is the Sharpeville and the Soweto, not of the Palestinians. Because the Palestinians have seen bigger and more massacres than those that which took place on the Mavi Marmara. Every year for 62 years, from Deir Yassin through to the attack on Gaza in December 2009, January 2010. Not of the Palestinians, but of us, the people who stand with them. The Sharpeville and the Soweto. And we must change ourselves. This is not a movement of activists. It must become a movement of people, of social forces, of the mass democratic forces that can transform the lives of the Palestinian people. Remember, the apartheid forces could murder 69 people in Sharpeville. They could gun down Hector Peterson and hundreds of school students in Soweto. They could execute and torture Steve Biko. They could assassinate Chris Hani. But Nelson Mandela walked free. Apartheid did fall. Gaza will be liberated. This siege will go down. The apartheid wall will fall. Together. Jerusalem, Viva Palestina, Viva Palestina, Viva Palestina.